Welcome back, everybody. Today we got another exciting video. I want to talk about what people need to be keeping in mind as they're entering into their last year of their graduate school studies and as they're going to start looking for a postdoc position. So if you like this kind of content, make sure to give it a thumbs up so I know that you like it and we can make more of these videos. And as always, if you have questions, make sure to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer everything that's in the comment section, and I do try to make videos about comments people leave that I think would be, you know, applicable to a broader audience. So this was actually something that somebody had written about in the comments section. So make sure to leave those down below. So as you get into your last year of graduate school, you're gonna be starting to apply for a postdoc position. So the first question that we should talk about is about when in your last year should you be applying? So what I would say is that you need to have a conversation as you're getting towards the end of your graduate school and find out when your PI thinks that you're gonna be ready to graduate. That's the first thing you need to do. So let's say that right now, we're in November and your PI is telling you, yeah, I think that by next October, November, you know, you should be ready to defend. If that's the case, then you're gonna need to start thinking about postdoc positions. I would say that about 6 months away from when you're gonna be defending is when you need to start looking for a postdoc position. It takes about six-ish months for most people to find a postdoc position. Now, some people could do it a little bit faster, some people it's a little bit longer, but let's say that about 6 months is a good bet. So that means that if you're gonna be wrapping up in about November, that about next May coming up is when you need to start applying. So what you're gonna need to start doing now is gathering a list of the places that you're gonna want to apply to. So that could be people in specific departments and specific institutions. It could be leaders in specific areas that you want to research. You know, there's a whole bunch of different ways that you could go about finding who it is that you want to apply to for their lab. Maybe we can make a video on that. You know, let me know in the comments if that's something that you'd be interested in hearing, how you can think about who you might want to be applying to and in what lab. So as you gather that list, then you're gonna need to start thinking about your CV and what you need to be doing when you apply. Now, a common question that I get, and I think it's a really good question, is, you know, if I have a publication that isn't accepted yet, it's not in press, it's not actually in a journal, it's something that I've submitted and it's going through peer review, do you think that I need to wait for that publication to finish peer review before I apply for a postdoc? I think the answer to that is no. Now, obviously, a paper that has gone through peer review and is accepted is stronger than a manuscript that's still in peer review. However, you know, having something going through peer review is a lot stronger than just not having anything from your dissertation, you know, being ready to be submitted. If you tell somebody, well, you know, I'm wrapping up my PhD, I'd like to join your lab, and they start asking like, okay, have you published anything? And your answer is no, I haven't. That's not a very strong answer. They really want to see that you've published something. But if you come back to them and you say, well, you know, we have something that's been written up, it's been submitted to Journal X, and it's currently going through peer review, that tells them that you're on your way to having a publication. And as a graduate student, you know, having a publication is ideal. Having two would be, you know, the best case scenario. I mean, I guess you could have more, but having two would be really, really strong. But even just having one that's in the process of going through peer review, it lets them know that you've thought about publishing, that the PI you're working with has thought about it, that you've gone through the process, and that you've, you know, actually know what the peer review process is all about. It's a very different thing to go through peer review. And so being able to say that you've done that really is going to be able to help a little bit. Now, what are some different things that you could do to try to add on to your CV, you know, in that last year or so? So there's actually a few that come to mind. The first is, if you haven't already, try to, you know, speaking of peer review, actually perform peer review. And so as a graduate student, it may be hard for you to be invited to be a peer reviewer. You may not have the connections. You may not be known as an expert in a particular field. You know, you haven't published anything. So it's not like an editor is going to be able to pull up your publication and say, oh, so-and-so published on something similar to this. Maybe I can invite them to peer review. But what you can do is you could go to your PI and say, hey, listen, next time you're going to do a peer review, can I please also participate in the peer review process with you? This way you can add that on to your CV that you've peer reviewed for whatever journal that it is. And when you're at the graduate school stage, I mean, at any stage in your career, really, but especially at the graduate school stage, each line that you add to your CV is a big difference. So that's one way that you can really increase the length and breadth of your CV. Another way is to apply for some sort of funding. Now, this could be for a graduate, school level grant, or it could be for something like a training grant for a postdoc. But you know, even if you're going to be leaving, so for example, when I was sort of almost on my way out the door, I wasn't quite, it was about a little bit over a year before I was going to wrap up, I actually applied for a fellowship for graduate students. Now, my PI knew that if I had gotten it, you know, it really wouldn't have done much of anything because I was going to be leaving anyways. However, going through that experience was really helpful. And what it allowed me to do is put on my CV that, like, I've submitted this grant. And then when I went and I talked to PIs, I was able to say, you know what, like, I know that you're going to eventually want me to write a postdoctoral grant. And I've already gone through the process of writing a grant. I know what it means to write, like, you know, the facilities and the materials and come up with your animal justification. And I know what it means to put together a research proposal and how to format and how to put in, you know, the citations that I need. So going through that, even if it doesn't get accepted, or even if it's something that, you know, at the end of the day, you wouldn't necessarily use all that much because you're going to be leaving, it really is helpful in demonstrating that you've gone through that process. Other things that you can do to help is if there's any way that you could be involved in any kind of teaching, mentoring, anything like that, that you could put on there. And I think the last thing that you really need to try to do is get yourself out to conferences and try to add on an extra couple of conferences that you could attend to, especially if you could somehow eke out a oral presentation conference. Being able to say that you've given oral presentations at a larger conference is really helpful. And I think that if you could do these things, you could really eke out a bunch of extra lines on your CV that'll make it a lot stronger. And really what you're trying to do in that last year is paint the picture of, okay, I've gone through graduate school, I have a firm understanding of my particular topic that I researched, I know then how to apply that, like how to write papers about it or grants about it or give talks about it, and let them know that you're moving to that next step, not just how to perform the research, but then how to actually communicate that research written and verbal. And that's really the important thing. And if you could do that, I think it's really gonna help to make you stand out from other, you know, people that are applying for postdocs. Cause it is competitive, I think, to get these postdoc positions. You know, there's only so many openings, and with funding being harder and harder to get, it just means that PIs just have less money to go around, meaning that they just can't have as many postdocs in their lab. So I hope everybody found this video helpful. If you did, make sure to leave it a like down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.